Mr. Gamache, we're going to have to do that again here at 7 o'clock. Get it on the live stream here. Hey, people at home, they got to hear it too.
Well, you should have told me that. I wouldn't have started. Wants to do it again. Y'all want to do it again?
Hold on. All right, good evening, live stream virtual audience. Welcome to our spring 2021 spring concert. And we got a couple small groups to treat you with before the band tonight. So first off this evening, we want to welcome the French Horn Quintet under the direction of Mr. David Gamache. Thank you. This group practices and rehearses over at the Bachman School, and there's another group that meets on another day of the week, and they're actually having a full French horn concert at the end of May. So look for an announcement on social media with that. And a lot of our students that Mr. DeMarche has taught for many, many years here are going to be a part of that. That first tune was the theme from Jupiter, the famous Gustav Holst piece. But that melody that you heard was the old English melody, I Vow to Thee My Country, which was sang at Princess Diana's funeral, just a long-standing melody for England. This next tune was actually written by a local Chattanooga composer, David Holsinger, a piece written for band. This is on a hymn song of Philip Bliss, arranged for this French horn ensemble.
Thank you.
we send them back to the bleachers. We also want to recognize little Emily Campbell there in the center. She's one of our seventh grade French horns that was invited to that old person's duty over there. Emily's actually going to be in the marching band with us next year as an eighth grader, which has only happened, I guess, three other times since the school's been open. And I actually had to call Bands of America since we're doing competitions again next year and see what the rules were. But we knew that she could handle it, and that's going to be a great French horn mellophone section. I think we got, what, nine of them next year. It's going to be great. Yeah. Next up, we have a little chamber ensemble that these guys created on their own. They got it together, and then a couple weeks into it, sent me an email and asked if they could rehearse at the school. And I never heard of them until last week. They were hiding in some cubby hole somewhere. Should have said that Dr. Sharp's in here. I'm just kidding. Great kids. But they picked their own music, found it online, and been rehearsing. So they're playing Infidel Overture.
Thank you.
Job, guys. As we have our Marimba Quartet coming up here next, and these guys go back to the bleachers, being in a small group like this, whether or not it's the quintet or the quartet, is such a tough experience because it's one of the first times that our students have ever heard how they sound alone in a group, because you can really hide in a band, especially of our size. And these guys are just getting so mature as musicians, going through those things like that. And most of them, when you talk to them, they talk about that music more than they do the band music. They really enjoy those types of things. Our Marimba Quartet meets on Fridays, one day a week, and they learn all sorts of music, and they're just going to play one of the many tunes that they've worked on this semester with Matt Broom. And this is some Mozart. This is Eine kleine Nachtmusik.
To teach the DP kids about classical form. So very, very good job. All these groups up here, very outstanding. So give us a couple of seconds. We're going to get reset here. We're going to play a little jazz for you. We'll be back in just a minute.
Thank you.
All right, so welcome once again. We're going to play a little bit of jazz for you here. We recently had our Swing, Swing, Swing event, which is a little bit different than we had done it in the past, but did it out here in the quad, and for those of you who came, we certainly do appreciate it. We had a really good crowd. We had a lot of fun playing outside for everyone, and, you know, we worked up about an hour's worth of music, you know, over the course of this semester, so this is a lot of music for a high school jazz group. I tell them all the time, when I go play gigs, we've got a book, you know, this thick, and sometimes we'll play for 3 hours, and there are tunes that we'll play that we'd never seen before, and that makes it a lot of fun. We're going to play three tunes from that concert. We're going to start with a tune called Tiger of San Pedro, and we are going to feature Grady Sharp on this one. We hope you enjoy it. Oh, by the way, you just got through hearing three wonderful groups that I'm very proud of. Classical music, right? Everyone was quiet, and everyone was, you know, very respectful of the group. Now, this is jazz, okay? You don't have to be quiet for them. If you hear something you like, let them know, okay? Let them know. Feel free. All right, we hope you enjoy this. Tiger of San Pedro. Mr. Broom, can you hear me okay? Now you can? Okay, good. Sorry. I'm supposed to stand right here, so sorry, online people. But we're going to feature the trombone section. Also, we're going to feature Will Marsden and Luke Robertson and Claire Biddle. You don't play on this one? Oh, sorry. Grady? Okay, so those three folks in the solo section. So we hope you enjoy it. This is Cage-Free Trombones. I see one of our bass trombone alumni up here. Micah Smith helped us make this tune. He helped us make this tune famous, so this is for you, Micah. A tune that Trombone Shorty made famous, and it's called Butt Jump, and we hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you.
time. This is the giant band, as we call it. And if you were at the December concert, you probably saw Miss Sienna's debut, her conducting debut with us, concert band-wise. And unfortunately, tonight is going to be her own farewell. Over here, she's taking lessons from Dr. Binker, who's here, Jonathan Cathell in town, and she's just been such an addition, and I know Mr. Walker and I like to sit back and not wave her arms. So without further ado, this is Sienna Rodericks and the Florentiner March.
Thank you.
CCMEO and all of our seniors. It's been kind of bittersweet the last couple weeks because they've all had different last days because of the different tests that they're all taking, and they're just kind of trickling out of the band room. And tonight's not our last night. We've got our band banquet on Saturday and get to wish them farewell at graduation here in a couple weeks. The next tune is a John Williams tune, and if you're familiar with John Williams, we all know his music from Star Wars and Indiana Jones and all the famous tunes or famous movies that we love, because John Williams really made those movies. You know, without his music, they wouldn't be memorable. And Saving Private Ryan is one of those movies that you don't really think about who composed that, because you think of the history behind the Normandy invasion and all that. But John Williams did compose the soundtrack for Saving Private Ryan. And there's a chorale in the middle of that that's just gorgeous. It's called Hymn to the Fallen, in honor of those that lost their life on D-Day, June the 6th, 1944. On the movie, the Boston Symphony performs that tune, and it was written for orchestra and kind of condensed down into a band version a couple years ago by Paul Lavender. So we're going to perform that for you tonight, and this is one of my favorite tunes. It's a tough one, but it's gorgeous. We hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
That's a beautiful piece, isn't it? Did this several years ago with another group I had, and we had a choir that did it with us, and it was absolutely unbelievable. We're going to hear some more John Williams here soon, don't worry. But our next piece that we're going to perform you is
Deus Ex Machina.
I've been mispronouncing this since forever, so I decided to let
Deus Ex Machina
do it for me. This is a piece written by Randall Standridge, and he references his 11th grade English teacher. They were studying theater, some theater literature, and things like that. And
Deus Ex Machina
was brought up, and he admits that he doesn't remember anything after
Deus Ex Machina,
but that it just inspired him. He was thinking about, you know, a god that had, you know, these. It means god from the machine, and that had all these, you know, speakers and crazy things going on. So he decided to write a piece for it called
Deus Ex Machina.
So we hope you enjoy I guess I wore Google out. So we hope you enjoy Deus Ex Machina.
Thank you.
We try to do one classic band piece on each concert, and if you're at the December concert, you got to hear Green Sleeves by Alfred Reed. In the previous concert, back in March, you got to hear the famous Washington Post March. Tonight we're going to do a piece by John Barnes Chance called Variations on a Green Folk Song. Again, one of the most famous pieces for a band group played all over the, not just the country, but all over the world. John Barnes Chance was in the U.S. Army band back in the 60s and was stationed in South Korea. And he was on the bus one day and heard this beautiful traditional Korean melody that he knew he had to put in his next composition. And, you know, the rest is history. It's just, it's catchy, it's got that gorgeous moment in the middle and exciting parts throughout, and that's why groups all over want to play this before they graduate from high school or college. Just one of those that sticks with you. This is Variations on the Korean Folk Song. quite a few seniors that this is their last performance with us, even though we have the band banquet. But we want to recognize them. We have quite a few of them, and they've been a lot to all of us. Even the young freshmen that just got to meet them this year. But we've had them in the band room for 7 years and watched them grow up. And just like we tell you every year, it's tough. This is my, I'm sure Shelby too, this is my least favorite time of the year because you guys say goodbye to these guys. But we asked them to fill out a survey a few days ago of where they were going to college, what they were studying, what their ACT score was. We were curious. And how much money they got in scholarships. So we added all that up just to show you what kind of kids these are, and adults these are, I should say. But close to a 30 average, almost a 29 average ACT score, over $750,000 in scholarships just from this group of 16 seniors. You'll stand when we recognize you. First off, we have Eleanor Alley. She'll be studying mechanical engineering and technology at the Rochester Institute of Technology and continuing to play her clarinet at the school.
Next, we have Luke Anderson.
There he is right there. Wave, Luke.
Luke will be attending Austin P. University, and he's going to be studying music education and also playing percussion.
Matthew Ashline, studying biochemistry and molecular biology at the University of South Carolina with a minor in music and also continuing to play his bassoon in South Carolina.
We have another percussionist, Audrey Bevins. Where are you, Audrey? Stand up, right? There's Audrey. Audrey's going to be attending MTSU University while she's going to continue to play percussion. She's going to be studying communications.
Next up, we have Adam Burton, who's going to be studying systems and industrial engineering at the University of Alabama Huntsville and also continuing to play saxophone.
Next, we have Elizabeth Funk. There's Elizabeth right there. Elizabeth is going to be attending MTSU, where she's going to begin studying pre-veterinary medicine. So if we need a vet, you're going to call her pretty soon. Elizabeth Funk.
She's also really good at throwing axes, too. We don't talk about that. I watched her mother on Zoom throw an axe one time. It was pretty scary. Or no, it was Leah. Next up, we have Austin Hensley, studying mechanical engineering at Mississippi State University. Micah, from all the Instagram posts I see all the time, I don't even think you go there anymore.
Roll Tide!
Austin will also be playing his tuba at Mississippi State.
Emmy Milligan, who's right behind us right here on the flute. Emmy is going to be studying music business and audio production at MTSU.
Right. Sienna Roberts, studying psychology at UNC Chapel Hill.
My favorite trombone player is Christopher Scott. Hey, Christopher, there he is. Christopher's going to be studying accounting at Chattanooga State.
Hold your applause, Mike. Braden Smith, studying industrial and systems engineering at Mississippi State University.
Meredith Stafford, there she is right over there on the flute. Meredith is going to be studying creative writing at Berry College and is going to continue playing the flute as well. Meredith Stafford.
Julia Song will be studying animal science and pre-vet at MTSU while playing in the band with their clarinet.
Is Sarah Renetti over here on saxophone? Sarah is going to be studying music education at the University of Tennessee, and she is also going to continue playing her saxophone at UT.
It's my turn. Go balls, my guy. Go balls. Next up, we have Abby Frank. Abby, stand up. She's going to be studying international relations at the MTSU Honors College.
All our seniors, everyone, all of you stand up for one more quick round of applause. All seniors, stand up, please. Thank you. Thank you for your service. Thank you.
Okay, so, as promised, we have more John Williams for you. I was disappointed that we weren't able to perform it on May the 4th, be with you. But that's okay. Yesterday we had Revenge of the Fifth. And now for another faction of Star Wars fans, we have Revenge of the Sixth, which sounds more like Sith. Or you could look at it this way. Six is the number of bounty hunters that Darth Vader hired to go find Han Solo in Empire Strikes Back. Y'all remember that? Or Order 66, which was the order the Emperor gave for them to turn on the Jedi. So there's lots of six things that you could do for today. Seriously, though, John Williams has, we've talked about this many times, just kind of sitting in my office, you think about, Beethoven and Mozart and all of those guys. They were rock stars back in their day. John Williams is that today. And movie music is really the new classical music of our era. And he is the pioneer. I mean, he's the greatest. He's worked with many directors. His really first big blockbuster was Jaws, if you remember. And that was with Steven Spielberg, and he's done stuff with George Lucas and all kinds of other directors. Just every time he writes a score, it's genius. And there was a story that he likes to tell when Steven Spielberg was going through asking him to write the music for E.T. You remember E.T.? He told him the story, and he showed him some footage, and John Williams looked at Steven Spielberg and said, "I really think that you're going to need to find a better composer to do this. I don't know if I can do this." And Steven Spielberg looked at him and said, "I would, but they're all dead." So what we're going to do for you tonight, we're going to play what's called the Star Wars Marches. It's going to take us through many of the episodes. It's going to take us through Return of the Jedi, A New Hope, unfortunately, it's going to take us through episode one, but it is a fun tune that we're going to play there. We hope you enjoy this. May the 4th be with you, Revenge of the 5th, Revenge of the 6th, Order 66, and 6 bounty hunters to you. We hope you enjoy tonight, and here is Star Wars.
Thank you.
four big hands for our seniors in their 7 years of music. Great night. If you don't mind allowing your student to help us bring a thing or two back to the band room, we'll see you guys on Saturday.